What's up everybody, Matt Moran here for another car review. This is of course the all-new 2020 Mini Cooper SE. Huge thanks to Mini for bringing me out here to Miami to review the all-new electric Mini for you guys today. So about the SE version, so completely electric and it's very cool looking but also very familiar Mini of course. So it is still based on the current generation Mini and so you have a very familiar look up front here, but there are a lot of unique accents here for the SE version. So you have these greenish yellow accents which are very cool and really help this vehicle to stand out. That whole grille is unique here for the electric version. It has a little slit in it to give it some better airflow, but then you have this hood scoop up here which is the same as it would be on a normal Cooper S, but it is blocked off here on this one. So that helps to give you better airflow but still gives you the link, since this is actually labeled as a Cooper S, it just happens to be electric. So it still gives it that sportier look. But I do love you. It's standard LED headlamps here in all electric Minis, which is a great thing that usually is an extra cost option in other Minis. So great that that's standard here on the electric. But then you have these really cool, unique wheels here. These are 17-inch wheels that are optional, but I really love that greenish yellow accent once again on those. But you do get 16-inch wheels as standard, and so those also have a unique look to them. But I really like these 17s. You get more of these accents here on the fenders. The mirrors here are that same color. Now, if you don't like that color, you don't have to have it. So you can option your electric Mini to look pretty much like a standard Mini as far as the accents and stuff go. So you don't have to have that, but I think it's a fun addition for sure. And then going out to the back there, again, looks very similar. Now, of course, you don't have any exhaust tips, so they've redone the rear bumper and everything to give you better airflow. And that's cool. You could also see, of course, the charging port there where you normally would have the fuel door. And so very easy swap there to just put that in there. A few other little things to note here as far as the look of the vehicle here. So it is actually 18 millimeters higher, but because of the battery pack on the floor, it's actually got a 30 millimeter lower center of gravity. So a nice little addition there, which should help in the handling department as well. And otherwise though, you know, I just still love this body style of the Cooper S, and you know, especially I'm glad this is a two-door because it really gives it a smaller footprint than a lot of other electric vehicles that this competes against. Right, so the interior of the Mini Cooper SE. Well, it's a very familiar Mini, but very nice actually. They gave it a lot of really nice standard equipment here for the electric version. So first, sitting down in these seats. Now this one is a higher trimmed version. This is not the base model. This is more like a fully loaded version, but there's gonna be three different trims. This is the top one, but these seats are fantastic. They're all the same shape. It's just this one has this nice quilted leather, which is really soft and supple and feels great. But these seats are just sporty but comfortable at the same time. They're also heated here in this version, although that's not standard. But overall, very comfortable seats. Next is the steering wheel, which is a classic Mini. Very, very good. Has a great 9-3 grip. These comically large 10-2 notches. And a few buttons here on it, but overall, you know, not too complex or anything. I like the little Union Jack here on the bottom of it. The gauges here in the electric Cooper are totally unique. So you have this small, I think it's a 5.5-inch digital display. And it's very cool, but it's nicely simplified as well. There isn't really a whole lot of customization here. You just have your speed basically there in the middle. You have your power meter on the left and your range meter on the right and a few other little things, you know, speed limit and a couple other things there. But overall, fairly simple, but everything you need there. And I think it gives it a little bit more of a futuristic feel having it be all digital as well. You also do have a heads up display here in this one, but I don't think that's standard either. This digital display though for the gauges is standard. So nice to have that. You also have a Harman Kardon stereo here, which is an option, but another nice option to have. Coming over to the center of the dashboard here, you have the classic Mini Cooper setup here with the screen now where the speedometers used to reside back in the day. And I like the color ring you have, which changes depending on drive modes and things like that. And so this one has the optional 8.8-inch display, but as standard, you do get a 6.5-inch touchscreen display, which still does have Apple CarPlay as standard. Still no Android Auto, unfortunately, but the fact that you get that screen as standard, and also you get navigation as standard in all electric Minis, which is usually an extra cost option with Mini and with basically everyone. And so the fact that that's standard is great. And so this screen is really nice. I love the setup of it. It's very simple. It's much easier to navigate, honestly, than BMW's setup personally. And so I really like the way it is. Now, it is still a few extra button presses to go into like tuning the radio and things like that. But you do have these shortcut buttons here under the volume knob, and you can program those to be anything you want. So that nicely simplifies it whenever you're actually living with one of these and you own one.
you can set it all up and it'll be very streamlined in your own experience. But to control it, it is touchscreen, so you can control it with touch, or you can use this little control wheel down here, which also has a several, you know, buttons here for shortcuts. So that's really great. Beneath that screen though, you have your dual zone auto climate control, which is also another standard feature here in the electric Mini. Again, something that's usually an extra cost option. And so great that they have that here, and then just a row of buttons and a row of toggle switches, including, you know, one is for adjusting your regenerative braking, also for sport mode and a few other things there. And so, you know, there's a few buttons and switches here, but it's really nicely simplified. Again, I really like how they keep these Minis very unique but very simple at the same time. And then beneath that, you'll see your power outlet and two USB jacks, and then also your first cubby right there beneath that, which is a good size. Then you have two cup holders, and then coming over to the doors, you'll see another pocket here which you can put some stuff in, but not large enough for a bottle, but still a good pocket nonetheless. And then you have the center armrest, which is a little cheap feeling, honestly. This whole interior feels very high-end, except for the center armrest, which feels kind of vinyl and a little cheap. But anyway, you open that up, and this one, as optioned, has this wireless charging pad, but that isn't a standard thing, but nice to have that. Otherwise, you'd have a little bit of a larger bin there. And then you open up this bottom part, and you'll see a little tray here, but there isn't any additional storage outside of that one little pocket there. So, you know, storage is okay. I would say it's maybe average or slightly below average compared with other vehicles in this segment that usually have a normal storage bin here or something like that. Backseat space in the Cooper here, it's the same as any other Mini. Thankfully, there is no space sacrifices because of the electric powertrain. So backseat's the same as any other two-door Cooper. So I'm 5'9", I'm sitting behind myself. I still have a couple inches of legroom to spare there, plenty of headroom as well. And so you could easily fit four adults in here as long as the driver and the front passenger aren't too tall. And so still a very practical vehicle in that regard. If you do need more space, you want four doors, and you want an electrified option from Mini, they still do have the Countryman plug-in hybrid you can get, and that's obviously going to be a lot roomier. And that also applies to the trunk space, which isn't a lot here in the Cooper S. And so you still have that same very deep trunk here, though, in the electric version. Again, no compromise there either. And so it's, you know, pretty deep space, but obviously just not very long or very wide. Smaller than most other hatchbacks that this competes against. But again, that's what gives this Mini its small footprint. But, you know, still has plenty enough space for a couple of duffel bags or a couple of, you know, carry-on size suitcases. Things like that should stand up very nicely in there. And so overall, still a sufficient amount of trunk space. All right, so let's turn it on and go for a drive. So it has the typical round key as any other Mini, but I still really like this feeling. It's very cool. It has Mini on the back there. But of course, it's keyless access, keyless entry, and push button start. So there's this little start stop toggle here, and you just hit that. Very futuristic. I like that. They really made the whole electric thing very fun here. And you have some dings, but then it turns on and it's ready to go. Alright, so setting off here in the Mini Cooper SE. So, I think the first thing that I'm noticing actually is this pedestrian warning hum that you hear at low speeds, and that's something that legally they have to have, but also something that's important just so that people can hear this vehicle coming. But it's a very cool little electric hum that you can especially hear louder on the outside, but you can hear it as well on the inside here, and it's a cool little touch. Another thing that I'm noticing right away is the one pedal driving, which is the default driving mode here in the Mini, is that it'll do the braking as soon as you start letting off of the gas, and it's pretty aggressive regenerative braking, so of course it wants to recuperate as much of that energy as possible to keep the battery topped up. But it's definitely something you take some practice, and obviously there's other electric cars that do a very similar thing. And if you don't like the regenerative braking that aggressive, you can, there's a little toggle switch here next to the start button where you can go to a more relaxed coasting type mode where it'll drive like a normal vehicle. So that's nice to, you know, give you the option one way or the other. Obviously you save more, you know, and you can regenerate more through the battery if you can do that one pedal driving. It just takes a little bit of practice to master, because if you just let off like you normally would, you're going to slow down way faster than you're wanting to. So just a little thing to practice, but obviously it being an electric vehicle, very quiet. And the fact that it's a Mini, it's a little more premium than a lot of the other electric competitors, even in this price range. And so I think this is definitely a lot more refined than a lot of the competitors are. And it's just a little more solid feeling too than, you know, something like a Nissan Leaf or things like that. I mean, you have nice thick doors here in the Mini. Everything is very solidly built. It's got that those BMW roots, which I've always appreciated about these newer Minis. And it's a very punchy, of course, too. So it's front-wheel drive. You have an electric motor. It's a single-speed transmission. and you do 184 horsepower, 199 pound-feet of torque. Of course, with an electric motor, you have instant power, and so we're just stuck in some city driving here, but that's where it really comes in handy, because you can zip in and out of traffic and get up to speed very quickly. I mean, it springs forward, and many even said that, you know, the acceleration for those first, few dozen meters, it'll keep up with a lot of pretty quick sports cars. So I mean, really nice to have that, and especially around town and stuff, it makes for a very zippy driving experience. You can also have a pretty decent 0-60 time, and those higher speeds also come pretty quickly. 0-60 is 6.9 seconds here for the Cooper SE, and so that puts it very close. I think a normal gas Cooper S is like 6.5 seconds 0-60, so you're very similar performance here. It's right on par with a lot of the other electric vehicles in that regard.
Unfortunately, the traffic never cleared up enough in Miami for us to do a sustained acceleration run, and there weren't any roads where I could even attempt to do anything close to a 0-60, so I don't have a reaction for you guys, but I will say that even riding passenger in this vehicle on the highway on the way back, passing power is plentiful, and with that electric motor, I mean, you have instant punch, so I don't think that anyone is going to be wanting for more power here out of the Cooper SE.
Another thing that's really great about the Mini here in city driving is that it's got these smaller dimensions. You know, compared to basically all the other competitors, this is a little bit smaller, obviously just being a two-door setup here instead of the four doors you have with most of the competitors. And so, parking and just getting in and out of traffic and stuff is much easier here in this, and it gives it a much more playful attitude than a lot of the other electric vehicles as well because of its smaller dimensions. And of course, Mini's trademark handling and, you know, their go-kart type feeling, and this certainly has that a lot. Throttle response is immediate, of course, being an electric vehicle. The brakes, whenever you do need to use them, if you aren't using the one pedal driving, brakes are also very responsive and feel, you know, very similar to other BMW and Mini setups. Steering actually has a nice resistance to it as well. I'm just in the normal mode. There are several different drive modes here. So there is a sport mode, then there's a green mode, and then there's green plus. And green plus gets really aggressive, where it'll actually turn off the climate control, it'll limit your heated seat and all the other functions to maximize efficiency as much as possible. So that's kind of an interesting little thing that it'll do. But just in normal mode here, I do like that it's a little bit of a sportier feel than what you get with some of the other stuff out there. And so again, it all goes back to Mini being a little bit more of an enthusiast vehicle, a little bit more fun to drive. So for most of this drive, we've just been in city traffic here in Miami. So it's really, you know, showing how this vehicle is a great urban vehicle. So I don't really have too many opportunities to exploit both the power or the handling here in the Cooper SE. But, one thing that I will say, just, you know, kind of playing around here and swerving around within my lane, it's going to be a very good handling vehicle. Obviously, Minis are always very good handling vehicles, but this one has the advantage of having that battery pack in the floor here. And so because of that, you have a center of gravity that's actually 30 millimeters lower, despite the fact that the actual vehicle suspension is raised up 18 millimeters to give that battery enough ground clearance. But you still do have a lower center of gravity than our normal Cooper S. So that's going to give you a little bit of advantage. You do have some additional weight though. I think it's about 270 pounds heavier than a comparable gas Cooper S. So that obviously is because of those batteries once again. Speaking of that battery pack though, it's a 32.6 kilowatt hour battery pack. And so it'll do, according to the EPA testing cycle, 110 miles of range. So the European testing cycle quotes some much higher numbers, closer to 150, 170. But that's a much easier test than what we have here with the EPA test.
As far as charging goes, thankfully you have a pretty small battery, so it doesn't take too long to charge up. The fastest charge speeds that they're quoting here is you can get an 80% charge in 35 minutes. That's on a 50 kilowatt DC fast charger. Obviously, if you're on a slower charger, it will take longer. But again, because you're only dealing with a 32.6 kilowatt hour battery and only like 28 or so of that is usable, it does recharge pretty quickly.
So far, the meter in the car here seems to be lining up pretty closely with that. We started with a little over 110 miles of range and has been going down pretty predictably here. So it's a nice thing to drive, and you know, I would love to be able to push it on a back road or on an autocross course or something like that to really test the handling. So I honestly can't really weigh in on that too much, but I would expect it to handle very similar to other Minis. You do have some skinnier tires though. We're running 195 with tires, and they're 16-inch wheels as standard. This one has the optional upgraded 17-inch wheels, and so gives you a little bit of a lower profile tire there. But you know, I think despite the fact that you have, you know, skinnier tires, which are obviously there to help with the range and whatnot, I think it still does handle very good in city driving from the little bit I can gauge. But once again, I don't really have a lot of experience going around corners here. But, you know, just creeping through traffic and stuff here around Miami and now Fort Lauderdale, it's a very pleasant experience. And, you know, for this type of, you know, just commuting and doing errands and things like that, that most people will be doing with these, obviously is going to fit that very, very well. Another thing that's worth mentioning, though, is the ride here in the Cooper SE is very good. It's a very flat ride, but it is very, you know, soft. I mean, it's a little bit of a sportier tuning setup, like you would expect. If you've ever driven any other Mini, this feels very similar to all of the others. So not a whole lot of surprises if you're familiar with the Mini brand as far as the ride goes, but it really is a refined and very smooth driving experience as well. And I actually decided to turn off the regenerative braking's aggressive one pedal setting and went to the more relaxed low setting. And I've noticed that it is a lot more normal feeling. And I think personally, that would be the mode that I would want to drive in. Unfortunately, it does default to the one pedal driving each key cycle, so you are going to have to hit that button, but it's right next to the start button, so very easy to just hit one button, hit the other, and then you're good. But I think, you know, it still will do a little bit of regenerating, and whenever you hit the brakes, obviously, that will still get some regeneration done. But I think as far as the driving experience goes, it's easier to be smoother with this low regenerative mode, and so for me, I think it's a more normal experience, and that's kind of what I personally like.
The last thing I have to mention about the Mini is the pricing of it, and it really is a strong value in many ways. So they're starting out at $30,750 before incentives, and it's eligible for the full $7,500 federal tax credit. So that right off the bat brings it down to $23,250 for the base price. And remember, that base model is really nicely equipped with the standard LED lights, standard dual zone climate control, navigation, all that type of stuff is standard. And so that's stuff that you have to pay extra for, not only in any other Mini, but also in any other competitor. All the other stuff, you know, the Nissan Leafs, the e-Golfs, you got to pay extra for all that stuff and push all those well over $30,000. And so if you're okay with only having two doors and having the smaller space, you get a more premium vehicle for less money, and you get more equipment for less money than what you get with even these standard competitors. And I think the closest competitors to really compare this to are the Nissan Leaf and the Volkswagen e-Golf. Now, both of those have more electric range. The Leaf has 150 miles and the e-Golf has 125 miles of range. The Leaf also has an extended range version you can get as well. And the Leaf starts right around the same price. It's $29,990 for the Leaf, and that also is eligible for the tax credit and stuff. The e-Golf is about $1,000 less than the Mini, but you get much less standard equipment. And any of the other competitors that, you know, in the electric field are going to be at least $6,000 more. They do give you more range, but they're, you know, way more expensive. And not to mention, you know, in addition to that price of the base Mini EV here being $23,250, you can then get state incentives in some states to bring that even lower. And I think potentially the highest rebates when you combine them all puts this around $17,000 for a brand new Mini that has navigation, that has CarPlay, that has LED lights, you know, a really nice and premium interior. All these things for well under $20,000 in some cases. It is a phenomenal bargain. And I think, you know, most people are using electric vehicles these days as commuter vehicles and short range vehicles. And for that, I think the 110 miles of range is going to be plenty. I think most people's commutes every day are well under 110 miles. And so, you know, when you factor that in, the fact that it is a you know, vehicle that's short distances, and it does have a usable back seat still. So if you either don't transport people in a back seat a lot, or even if you do and they're okay with hopping in over, you know, the seat and sliding it forward and stuff, if they're okay with all that, I think this makes a phenomenal commuter vehicle, a phenomenal little errand vehicle, and can fit into, I think, most people's lives very, very well if, you know, they actually look into it and consider it. And so, yeah, I'm really impressed with just how strong of a value Mini has here with the pricing of the Cooper SE. They really came out swinging. It's also available in all 50 states, which is something that many other EVs aren't. So that's another important thing to note. It's a very compelling option, and yeah, I'm pretty impressed with it. It's a lot of fun to drive. It's a little punchier and, you know, a little bit more exciting than a lot of the competitors as well. So I think there's a lot to like here about the Mini Cooper SE. Huge thanks to Mini, though, for bringing me out for this opportunity. Let me know your thoughts on the Mini Cooper SE in the comments below. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Take care.